So we're in the West Herefordshire market town of Kington, and we're heading off up to the Hergest Ridge, which is a nice big bulbous hill, 422 metres. I'm actually walking a section of the Offa's Dyke, guys, which, as we all know, is the long distance path that starts up there in North Wales and finishes in South Wales at Chepstow. So I'm walking from the Hergest Ridge. I'm going to do a wild camp tonight and heading for Hay On Wye tomorrow. I'm just going to pop into this shop, get one or two supplies, and then possibly head to see an old friend of mine, Roy. We'll see if he's in. If he's in, I'll introduce you to Roy. He's a really far out old hippie. I think you'll enjoy him. All right. When I get to Hergest Ridge, I'll tell you all about it. What Hergest Ridge is, its significance culturally. Some of you may even have a clue already. And I'll share with you the area in which we're situated, which is on the border of Herefordshire and Radnorshire. Get some great views from at the top there of the Radnorshire hills, which are absolutely amazing, the Radnorshire forest. So I'll share all that with you when we get there. All right, guys, catch you up. Peace. Roy's not in, guys. So we're going to head for Hergest Ridge. Oh, good to see you, my love.
I'm so sorry.
Yeah, that's okay.
You take care.
Easy as you go. Remember Paul. Easy as you go. There's I've got a website. It's called Y Explorer, as in the River Y.
Yeah.
Paul's on there, so if you want to check it out, okay, you can't forget it. River Y, Y Explorer. Take care. Your name again before I go. Kath, that's right. See you, Kath. Take care now. Well, well, well. I'll tell you what, guys. I come all the way here to Wild Camp Hergest Ridge, which is on the border of Radnorshire in Herefordshire, and I haven't seen Kath, blimey, since we were 18, 19 years of age, 20 years of age maybe. So that's 30 years ago. That's so unusual, isn't it, guys? What a great start to this wild camp and this section of the Offa's Dyke. All right, guys, I'll catch you up. That was absolutely wonderful. Good start. Amazing. How about that, Paul? Just entering the Hergest Ridge. I really need to take my time because I'm camping on top of here. And there's still plenty of sunlight left, so yeah, just going to enjoy it. You know, look at the light. The trees bathing in the light. It's beautiful. Look at that, eh? Isn't that wonderful? Our local star. So here we are, guys. This is Paul, and I've been chatting to him for the last 20 minutes, probably, yeah, about the Radnorshire Hills.
Yeah.
What's Radnorshire like, Paul?
Fantastic.
The Radnor Forest.
Quiet.
Quiet.
Beautiful.
Full of wildlife.
Yeah.
Amazing gullies and valleys.
Yeah,
It's wild up there, isn't it?
Lots of paths.
Yeah, lots of paths. And this region, you know, we're on the Hergest Ridge, aren't we?
Hergest, we call it, yeah.
Hergest, you call it.
Locals do.
Oh, Hergest Ridge.
Yeah.
Right, okay. So, and you've been spotting, but what did you manage today?
Not a lot, really. Some golden plovers.
Golden plovers, wasn't it?
Yeah. A couple of kites, a couple of ravens.
Oh, right, yeah.
That's it, really.
I see two buzzards on the way in.
Yeah.
They were perching.
They're doing well.
Yeah, they're doing all right, aren't they?
Yeah. But in the spring and before skylarks.
Yeah. And we were talking about the old days, weren't we, Paul?
Yeah.
You know, how you could play tennis on the road.
And yeah, that's a long time ago.
Yeah, you get stopped 3 times in a day.
Yeah, definitely.
Okay.
The ambulance, a doctor and the barber, I think.
That's right, mate, isn't it?
Yeah.
Well, it's been good talking to you, Paul.
Yeah, nice talking to you.
And I hope to meet you again one day.
Possibly
walk or something of that nature.
Never know.
All right.
Yeah.
Good on you.
Great.
It's getting cold. It's going to be fresh tonight. All right, this guy's name is Stan, guys.
Yeah.
And
we're 81 and a half.
81 and a half. And I'll tell you what, he doesn't move like an 81-year-old. I can vouch for that.
Right.
But we were just talking about hardcore hikers who he's met up here, either camping in snow or hiking in
December 2010.
Yeah, a young girl you were talking about, wasn't it?
Then that was 2011.
That was 2011.
Who was doing the Offa's Dyke path from stars at Chepstow.
That's right.
To night.
But you helped her out, didn't you?
She stayed overnight with us in Kington.
Yeah, yeah.
Before the last stage to night.
Yeah, and she got back home safe.
She flew back to Holland the next day.
She was from Holland, wasn't she?
Yeah, from Holland.
Oh, international walker.
She was going to do it with her friend, but her friend packed pulled out.
I see.
So she did it by herself.
Yeah, yeah.
In bitterly cold weather, amazing.
So we're on the Offa's Dyke, guys, and we're meeting some wonderful people. First Paul, now Stan.
All right.
Good to meet you, Stan.
Good luck with your trip.
Yeah, you take care, all right?
Bye.
Easy as you go. 81 years of age, guys.
Bye.
Check him out. See you, Stan. How you in it? How about that? Stan, 81 years of age. Brilliant. Ancient scenes here, guys. Sun, stone, hills, mountains, Black Mountains over there. Absolutely amazing. What a region. Look at this, guys, Black Mountains. Now you get some idea as to where we are. Obviously the Radnorshire Hills, the Gwansesti Hill Range, and the Black Mountains. Wonderful. Glorious, absolutely glorious. And the late afternoon sun is spectacular. It's just, it's such a healing vibe. Yeah. Oh, that's wonderful. All right. Got some monkey puzzle trees here, guys. Good place to camp, I'd say. Yeah, this is a very good place to camp. I'm going to camp here, right next to the monkey puzzle. Great view of the Black Mountains in the morning. Got the view of the Radnorshire Forest and the Gwansesti Hill Range here. And the monkey puzzle was one of Paul's favourite trees. There you go. So that's where I'm camping. I've just made my decision. Go and find a flat spot. Tuck in there, nice and easy. Oh, this is a real nice spot. Yeah, I'm going to be happy here. Just going to take a photograph of the setting sun, which is just over there. So there you go. I'm pitched on top of Hergest Ridge, next to these wonderful monkey puzzle trees. That's Herefordshire. And my door is facing the Black Mountains in the morning. So the sun should be hitting those mountains and creating a real visual delight in the morning. We've got a crescent moon up there. This camera isn't really good enough to get it, but I'll try. Yeah, there it is. You can just about see it. So we've got a crescent moon. We've got a beautiful sunset. Black Mountains. And the Herefordshire countryside to the east. I'm looking east there, guys. I've walked this whole region with my twin brother. I've walked all over here. What I'm looking at, I've hiked with Paul. The memories are just everywhere. I am so, so happy that Paul and I did that together. So I'll say to any one of you guys, don't waste time. Get out there and create those special moments, because they may serve you well later. All right, get a bit of grub going. Tubular bells. The precursor to Hergest Ridge. Yeah. Wow, check that sunset out. Amazing. All right, guys. Turn that down and play you Hergest Ridge. Yeah. Hergest Ridge. Very different. Very experimental, wasn't he? Mike Oldfield. Quite cosmic. Inspired by all things dreamy and trancy. So we're up here on Hergest Ridge, and this is Hergest Ridge. Hey! Wow! Check that out over there. Thank you. That was wonderful.
Let the cold water do the job instead of using up fuel. All it takes is a bit of patience. See, that has cold soaked it really nicely. All I have to do really is add a little bit more water and put it on the heat.
Yeah, whilst I'm waiting for my food to warm up, I'd like to mention a friend of mine over in Holland. I am, of course, talking about Spijkerpoes. Not Spijkerpoes, but Spijkerpoes. I was talking to him about depression the other day. Anxiety and depression. And self-loathing, you know. Hating the self and hating the world in which you're in. And I was thinking about how the outdoors helps dissolve all that self-loathing. And he said that he had hurt his arm, and that for a moment he was disabled. And he said his arm was better. And I said, ah, all the better to hug the world with. And he got back to me and said, yeah, better a hugger than a hater. And that is very true. I said to him, very true. And that's what I come out here for, really, is to be a better hugger, if that makes sense. Spijkerpoes, I come out here to be a better hugger, to fill my life up full of joy, and to fill it up with all those good feelings that enable me to pass it on and share it with the world. Yeah, we've all had difficult times, and I have too. And there are lots of people that are caught in a spiral of negativity. Well, I say to them, you know, you're not limited. There are options available to you. You don't have to be wealthy, you don't have to be rich. Spijkerpoes ain't rich, he ain't wealthy. Nick, you know, the wayfaring man, he's not wealthy. You just have to keep it simple, you know. Yeah, keeping it simple. Sat in a tent on top of a high hill. Got the Black Mountains to my front, Radnorshire to my right, Herefordshire to my left. It's nice and fresh. Crescent moon. I'm warming some food up. There's no one here to bother me. I'm deep listening. I have good feelings, and that's all I need to dissipate those negative particles that build up in your body and in your mind. Enigmatic moon. Hello, enigmatic moon. I'm gonna get in my sack because it's freezing up here. So yeah, I'm not complaining. It's just darn cold. You can be rest assured that I'm going to wake up in an ice box in the morning.
Morning, guys. It was a long night, that. The sun set at around 4:30, quarter to five. And it is now just gone 5 to 8, coming up 8 o'clock, so the sun is rising. And we'll pop out shortly, see what the sunrise is like, and see if we've got any views. Meanwhile, these worked a treat. They worked a treat. My feet were toasty all night. And I put my jacket down the bottom as well. Because yeah, it did freeze. I've just wiped all the ice off the interior of the tent. So okay, I'll get my boots on and see what's going on. All right guys, peace. It's clear. We've got some views. Let's go and take a closer look. We've got the sunrise. We've got the Black Mountains. Should look resplendent this morning, shortly, and that's part of the Bracken Beacons. That's the eastern part of the Bracken Beacons. Beautiful. Let's have a look what the Radnorshire side looks like. That's the thing with where I am. I put my left arm out there. My right arm out there. My left arm is in Radnorshire. My right arm is in Herefordshire. That's the Radnor Forest. Looking moody. Bathed in cloud on the tops. Fewer lights. That's the Walton Basin down there. Yeah, my eyes are watering a bit. I just got up from a deep sleep and I've stepped out into a cold atmosphere. Yeah, the Walton Basin. It's, there are more historic sites down there than anywhere else in this region. Roman sites, Bronze Age, causeways, medieval sites. There's even a stone circle down there, Bronze Age stone circle, which is about 2,500 years old. You can see it in this video clip. Paul and I sat actually in the stone circle. It's a really far out place, and we had a great walk that day. We just chilled out and had a brew and had a really nice chat. And that was down the Walton Basin. Down there. All nice and neat. Ready to go. Well worthwhile. Good rest there. So we're fed, rested, the clouds are rolling in, and we're heading that way.
Well, I'm off the hill, guys. It's really good on top there. Enjoyed the camp. It's really fresh, invigorating. The morning was beautiful. Couldn't think of a better place to have breakfast. I've got one battery left. I'm heading into Gladestry via this track. So I'll do one or two shots, but I think the next time you'll see me is at the River Wye in Hay On Wye. All right, so I'll wrap it up there for now. Catch you up. Wye waters, coming in off the hills. Old school farming. The entrance would have been on the main road once. Yeah, look. That's a bygone era, isn't it, guys? Would have been horse and cart back then. Yeah, different pace back then. Wonderful. Still remnants of it left. Right, we're on the Offa's Dyke path. Back on the trail. Another one got caught in a fence. That's what happens out here. Come across a number over the years. All dead bar one. If you check out the link to the video below, Paul and I saved a lamb once from that very fate. It's a really good video. All right, onwards. What's your name, man?
James.
James, good to meet you, James.
Nice to meet you.
Farmer guys, James. What's this area now? This is Grantchester Hill Range over there, isn't it?
This would be top of Gladestry.
Gladestry. What's your name, bro?
Philip.
Good to meet you, Philip, man. Yeah, definitely. Philip and James, keeping our land right. Isn't it? Do you know what I mean? European, this guy, guys. He voted to remain. So did I, but we're debating Brexit on the top here, on these hills, with Philip as well.
Yes.
All right. Good stuff, guys. I'm going to get walking, I think. It's been really nice talking to these two, and all right, peace. They were really pleasant. That was really pleasant. I just love talking to the people working the land, you know. It's, as I said, my grandparents were farmers, and I just resonate. Do you get what I'm saying? Just resonate. Cheers, guys. James and Phil. All right. We are certainly walking through history, guys. Now, this is an old school farm, isn't it? Check it out. Look at that. Look at these stairs up here. Possibly had some pigs in there. Definitely livestock, look. Look at these old stairs. Look at that, covered in moss. I wonder what was up there. Why? There's the old farm. They'd have come out of there each morning. Busy little thoroughfare, look. Check it out. Nice operation once upon a time. Yeah. Good operation once. Quiet now. Farms like this don't make any money, do they? Look at this. This old barn. Probably carts in there once upon a time. Would have been carts in there once upon a time. Ah, it's a tractor, just like my granddad's tractor. Used to ride on a tractor like this when we were kids. Steel seat, look. Yeah, steel seat. Ah, it's just like my granddad's. Exactly the same. All right. That's an old bale loft, isn't it? Reminds me of my grandparents' farm, actually. About the same size. Wow, beautiful. That's the River Arrow, guys. I walked this in 2014 with Paul. More links below. Good videos. Those videos are on another channel. You may not know that I've got another channel, but those early videos are on a channel called Mark on the Way. All right, check them out. This is New Church, guys, and there's a cup of tea in there. So let's check it out. They say there's a cup of tea in here. Oh, I see. It's a case of self-service and contribution. I'm going to fill my flask. That's what I'm going to do. There you go. Got everything you might need. Kettle. Just boiled some water. I filled that mug up with coffee. Coffee's in there, nice and warm. Got sugar, brown sugar. Whoops. Got some milk in there. Got some biscuits as well. So that's really nice of them. And I'm gonna leave some money somehow. I don't know where, but I'll leave a pound. All right, to New Church, thanks very much. That's really, really cool. That's lifted my spirits a bit. So I've got a nice flask of coffee for the remaining few miles. All right. Just grabbed a few biscuits. And where shall I leave this pound? I'll leave it there. There you go. Thank you. I'm rushing, guys. I've got an hour and 45 minutes to catch my bus. Well, I wouldn't call it rushing. I'm training, really, to be honest. And I'm enjoying it. I run a bit. And then I'll tab. That's what we used to do in Aldershot. Brown Barracks. Hard going. But very good. Ah, get to the top here. Heavy. Training and trying to get to Hay On Wye. Just get two things out of it. Kill two birds with one stone. That's hard going. I think that's about £30 on my back. Water. We can't do without it, can we? One of the things I've learned through walking these rivers is the precious nature of water. Absolutely awesome view, man. Beyond there is the River Mono, which flows into the Wye at Monmouth. It's fabulous country out the back there. Still got to make up some time. All right, we're doing all right. Got to get that bus though. Okay, let's get out of the way. Follow them, mate! All good. That's what that says to me. Offa's Dyke, brand new signs. That way. We are descending down into the valley. Who remembers that tune? Into the valley. The Skids, wasn't it? Into the valley. I forget the name of the lyrics. I forget the lyrics now. But what a cracking tune. Main road. We're near Hay On Wye. First sighting of the Wye. We'll be in town shortly. Isn't that beautiful? Sorry, beautiful badger. Bless your soul. Just the type of place for a cup of tea. Just listen to the brook. Cheers, guys. That was a good hike. It was really good. To everyone, departed and all. A babbling brook. After what was a full-on hike, it's good fun. All right, put camera away. Listen to the brook. Beautiful. Never seen so many swans together. Loads of them. This is where they hang out. There's the Wye, guys. There's the bridge into Hay On Wye. I have to be quick. Thanks for joining me. It's been a real pleasure. That was a tough tab back. If you want to give me a thumbs up, please do, guys. The hike, the scene, the camp. If you want to comment, you know me. I always get back to you. Comment below. Join in the debate. And if you want to subscribe for future videos, don't forget to hit the button below. All right, take care of yourselves. I'm at the bridge now, and I've got about a quarter of an hour to catch my bus. So that's pretty good going. Many thanks. Take care.